I received this question this morning, and it was regarding, I have a video on saving files with a macro to a specific location on your computer. And he says, I followed your instructions and it worked. I would like a display alert and prompt me yes or no if it's saving a duplicate. Well, I was thinking about that, and I thought that that was probably a pretty good idea. I have here a little thing here, and I've got my button isn't named, and this is C4 is where is the name of the file we're going to save it to. Now, if I click the button 1, it's supposed to save first test there, and then it comes up with file already exists. So this would be helpful if you have a number of people working on the file and you would like to know whether it's being saved already. So let me show you what the code looks like. So I will include this code in my description. This is basically the same old file that I'm using to save a file in a specific location. So it's dim path as string, dim file name 1 as string, and path equals C, users Barb Henderson, desktop demo. So I have a demo on my desktop, and I have first test XML SL. This is with the macro in it, and this is the file that it's saving. So that's why it didn't save, because we already have a test in here. Now to get the path, I'll review this. Basically what you do is you click in there, and you copy this, and you can see that that's exactly the path here. And don't forget the closing backslash and the closing quotation marks on your quotation marks on both sides of it. So that's the path. And as I was saying before, range C4 is what my name of the file is going to be. And so now, just so the ease of this, we've display alerts equals false. We've turned off the things. But here we're testing that it's going to search the path and the file name. And if that file already exists, then it's going to send a message box, file exists, and it's a go-to statement. And I have ende, which is just meaning that it's skipping all the rest of the steps and going to end of sub. So if it finds it, then it's going to tell you that file exists and go to ende. Now, if it doesn't find it, then it's going to go active workbook save as, and then space file name equals path and file name, so path with an ampersand, file name 1, which is our range C4, and the extension, ampersand, and then the extension in quotation marks, xlsx, and then comma, file format, xlOpenXMLWorkbook, and then end if. Applications, now we're turning the app display alerts back on, and then we're going to close the workbook that we're working on. So let's go back to my file. And let's change first test. Let's change it to second test. Okay, so now let's F8 through my code here. And so what we're gonna start with the beginning and see how it goes. We've gone through there and it's found the path. And the file name C4, which is second test now, and we're changing off, turning off our display alerts, and then it's saying, does this one already exist? And it doesn't. So now it's gone to the next one, and it's going to save as file name, path, second test, and in the desired location, end if. And then what we're going to do is we're turning on display alerts, and then it's going to close our active workbook. Okay, so now let's go back to my demo here, and there you go. We have first test and then second test. So it will not save it if it already exists, but it will save it if it's a new file name into the same directory. That's how you test to see if the file already exists before you save it in a specific location. Please subscribe.